ba hwefo nyina akwa ba e de ba Adepa News eso Adepa News ni asan beto ye naso de esu sinkuro ikura aye emrante wa mienu omo nya asuku kwan mu ewo Achimota School omo ye omadwen se ene e bra so se wo se ko school de beko nemu mu no omo ye dreadlocks omo ko duru ho no ma asuku benfo ni se emra makwan so omo de omo rasta e be ba school we mu ti sa de omo mpene so Emma school for ne Emba school. We enam so Emma Brant we abusia for the ababon tin say ya dea omu besiu eye school no Achimota school court. Na eduru wanu manu ma be yano. Na inchiremu etre se abai e de ababon tin etre eye Achimota school ni se emra Emma kwan se se wa ye utri wun en pese pese kra ubeti mi e de aba school wo. We enam so Emma abusia no akasa. Yonko tiye ni omokan.
Tyrone Iwas Magai is still wearing the white shirt and khaki trousers characteristic of an SHS Form 1 boy. But he's not the average Form 1 boy you'd find in any school. He was a senior school prefect in junior high school and awarded the best student at the time of his completion. He went on to attain aggregate 6 in the BECE, earning him a place to study general science at the prestigious Achimota School in Accra. However, one thing stands in the way of his dream, as he has been turned away due to his hairstyle.
When I got there, I was directed to a chapel, think Agri Chapel, but it was a chapel where the people wait. And that's the very same place they present the items they've been asked to buy. And when I got there with my staffs and everything, one of the mistress, she was packing the presented items into the cars. And she told me she wants nothing to do with me because of my dreadlocks. So I should pack my stuffs and everything, sit away from her stuffs. That's all the items collected. I should keep away from that place. And then she also said with the dreadlocks, they will not accept anything. So it's either I'm getting it all at that very same place. It's either I'm getting it off and coming to Achimota or that's it. But Achimota will no way accept it. Getting the first choice, Achimota was one of the very schools I've always wanted to school at. And so I was expecting they would just accept. But then thinking of bringing in the hair problem and telling me because of your hair, we quit, we push aside academics and everything and just focus on the dread first. I was a really bit shocked and surprised.
His father, Teriu, says he is scandalized by the actions of the school. He says he was told to cut his son's hair or find another school for him.
They said the headmistress was at a meeting, so they directed us to the assistant headmaster. And he wasn't in, so we waited a couple of minutes. When he came, we went to see him, and his response was, no, it's against the school's rules. If he has dreadlocks, he better go scrape it, or we should look for other school. You know, you can't judge somebody with their heads and reject them, you know. But they should consider such things and take it serious, you know, and make choices, take students by their caliber, what they can, or at least they could have accepted him and check if he's a rude boy or he's not somebody who is going to have bad influence on other kids. At least they should give a chance.
For Terio Magai and 17-year-old Tyrone, being asked to get a haircut is an abomination, an affront to the Rastafari religion. Central to their beliefs is the promotion of African culture. This means that Rastafarians emphasize what they call living naturally, adhering to specific dietary requirements and wearing their hair in dreadlocks. Fellow Rastafarian Raswad Nkrabia also had his son turned away on Thursday at the same school for wearing dreadlocks.
No, I wasn't expecting that, because in this day and age, one would not expect that kind of thing. Furthermore, what does his dreadlocks have to do with him studying and achieving whatever he needs to achieve in the school? You know, this is we are in a time now, this is an information age where information is all over the place. And dreadlocks has become a fashion statement all over the world, right? You see so many celebrities, so many multinational corporations are using dreadlocks to sell their products and all of that. So it's not anything strange. It's one of the most popular hairstyles today. So we went to the assistant headmaster And he basically said the same thing. As a matter of fact, he was bragging and boasting that they have done it to others before, last year and the year before, and they took them to court and they won. So they're not afraid of us going anywhere we want to go.
The parents say that they will do all they can to get their children enrolled in the school they chose, if it even means going to court.
Well, we are looking for the president to intervene, the president of this country. We want him to intervene, because if these people think they can violate the Constitution, then of course the president has to answer to that. He has to tell us why there are institutions in the country that is violating the Constitution. So we want to take it to the GES, and we want to take it to court. We want a class action lawsuit.
Over the years, stories like this have popped up across various schools in Ghana. In 2017, a parent seeking admission for his ward at the Accra Girls Senior High School was also denied because she had dreadlocks. Tyrone, who now faces a similar fate, says he will join his siblings in another school if push comes to shove.
Maybe I would go to St. John's with my sisters, because I have two of my sisters and my very best friend, Manasseh, he's also there. So I was considering then changing to St. John's. It's still worth it, because the school is no good as the students. Yeah, when we take Achimota and we eliminate all the students out, it's just a building. So having a dedicated soul in somewhere like St. John's, I think it still works out.
This is the Achimota School campus, and today it's much quieter than the situation here on Thursday, as first year students officially reported to school for the very first time. But that was not the case for Oheniba Nkwabia and Tyrone Magai, because they were sent away because of the hairstyle, that is dreadlocks. I have come here today to get a response from the school. I've been told the headmistress is the only one who can speak to the matter, but unfortunately has been locked up in a series of meetings for the better part of the day, and therefore it's unlikely that I'll get any response on this matter. For Child's Rights International, an NGO which seeks to protect the fundamental rights of children, the Achimota school must not deny the Rastafarian boys access to education based on their looks.
First, allow the child to have the access to the environment, which is the right of the child, which is very substantive. And if you are done with that, then if you feel that the makeup of the child do not conform to certain rules and regulations, and that will not affect the substantive right of the child, then negotiation must kick in with the parent and the child.
And here yet see a mofra omuko school, a watching water school, and ra omu chresse school mram, and ma kwine, and momon fan person, pese, and bas school, a busia forno, and yet se omu kasano. Metwaso akwa and semfu from dia udi weni ako shell or kwanso dia nyasem ketu akura. And men mam yenu akentinka mienu na jes omatia si rodi usuna ni tokwa pipe 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 ne se police ni anase security ni bi credit and fin fin opatan so omu makwa kora. We enam so emma o we tonensa na we ya tonensa we tonensa ena bako akuma. And the one that's a Uchashi or Queen. You can share video and embraces here.
Hey, 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 hey
And some elko so ewo kuro metwa so akọ nsem fufuro mu dia na na dudankwa ekufu adọ ye Ghana mampeni e de cars nkoa 40 eye duanan akọche eye National Disaster Management Organization eye nadmo fo so omunje no munfa nye adwuma o mampeni so ekasai ewo ebra o di cars no ehye nadmo fo ensa ye nkotie ni okan.
So NADMO is the first state agency I'm visiting in my second term as President of the Republic. And I'm particularly delighted that I'm the first sitting president to pay such a visit. Prior to this ceremony, government had already distributed motorbikes to all the 16 regions and to the 260 metropolitan, municipal, and district secretariats of NADMO. Today, I'm here to top this up with the handing over of 40 more brand new vehicles. Comprising one Toyota Land Cruiser, one Toyota Camry, one Toyota Hiace ambulance, one Mercedes-Benz rescue ambulance, one payloader, five Toyota Land Cruiser Prados, and 30 Toyota Hilux pickups. In the course of next month, 32 additional pickups will be presented to augment further the fleet of NADMO. This is by no means exhaustive, and I assure management and staff of NADMO of more in the coming years under my presidency. Government is undertaking all of these measures and making these investments because disaster prevention and mitigation are directly linked to the sustainable development of any nation. As we prepare to exit the dry season and welcome the rainy season, one of the major concerns we have grappled with over the years has to do with the slashing and burning of bushes as farmers prepare their lands for planting. I appeal to our farmers in all parts of the country to exercise the utmost caution in the process of preparing their lands for the farming season, especially in the use of fire. The rainy season with its associated storms will also bring in its wake its own challenges. And I urge NADMO to be prepared with the required relief items and come to the aid of persons in need and to those affected. In conclusion, let me reassure NADMO of government's continued commitment to resourcing it to help fulfill its mandate to the citizen of responding.
Abusia metu aso akwansem fufuro mu dia we eye nige ye kese pa ensem bi esekuleti wo social media enam eye Richard Agu ene abena obi atopa wedding no ehun allegations bebre ebetwa mo wedding we ase eye nra ena ensem bi epiepie ye a chese eye Richard Agu ne ex girlfriend na ye friend se eye comfort de babonti se o tam sika eye more than 30,000 ina de share abrantie kosi se odi wie ni military school e wo takra de wanya adwuma papa bia aye wo san no ekwa ware eye oba foforo e wo boase ena due ya me no kase ya aware ne koso gidigidi anya asem keto akra midin kan e de hunti ye kakra e de ebremu na ne a aba ne se sisi an Yami Adom, Ometimi, Aye, Wedding, no, every year, Yanko share videos, maybe send me a month for budget so you will die. That means Yanko Fosu to sell or the air comfort, Nurse, and comfort will die. Yanko share video, Kitua, we embrace here. Abusia, who share pictures are a trouble and a nice and Yami Adom, Wedding, no, a Timmy Abaso. Why a wedding every ewo, a bra bebome, ewo, or boise, Ashanti region. Abusia, Adepa News, I had a brother Macquina, Midimu, S. Did work on your back of one's national chair. And no ma etcher was so I ya or chip war. In Midimu S. F. M. Miss Amma de Pampa, to share video now, no subscribing. While like, what share, what comment, Eddie Amaya, Midimu S. Mano Atop.